Thank you, Honourable Speaker, sir, and I thank the Honourable Member for asking the question. I'll be short, and unless they provoke me, then I'll give a longer one. Honourable Speaker, say. Honourable Speaker, say our ministry recognises that air pollution is a major concern with regard to public health. Under Part 5 of the Environmental Management Act 2005, all commercial facilities are required to hold a valid waste disposal permit from the Department of Environment. So all commercial facilities, they must have a waste disposal permit. Of course, under certain limit, beyond that, they must have hold a waste disposal permit. Now, to determine that limit, they must come to the Ministry of Environment and say that, you know, we should be exempted because this is just minor amount that, you know, we're disposing. So it's Ministry of Environment determines. So eventually, all of them must have a waste disposal permit, and the various types of waste disposal permit that are issued by the department, it ranges from solid waste permit to air pollution permit. Air pollution permit are also required to businesses that build new structures that are potential sources to make significant contribution to pollution. These permit documents for air pollution sources would need to demonstrate compliance within the existing emission limits and with other applicable requirements, including work practices, example, the dust calming measures or watering a dirt road. You would have, you know, the number of times we get complaints from residents that these logging companies, the trucks are driving so fast and they are, you know, dust is emitted and it comes to our house, it gets into, we can't dry clothes, et cetera, et cetera. So there are things, the conditions that we give in the permit for them to do that, which, for example, that they must water the road in that particular interval, you know, during those times, et cetera. So these permits and the legislation also allow how air pollution sources will be monitored periodically by the department for their compliance and with and all applicable requirements on an ongoing basis. Thus, monitoring requirements are a very important aspect of the department's operations. So, Honourable Speaker, I say, briefly mention every commercial industrial facility that emits exhaust gases, smoke, steam, or dust from any of its premises must hold a valid waste disposal permit from the Department of Environment. Honourable Speaker, say it is a condition of every air pollution permit issued by the department that the facility must comply with the air quality standards under the Environmental Management Regulation 2007. So if there is an issue, any particular neighbourhood, they complain, then we get an independent body to go and do the measurement of that particular discharge. For example, cement factories, we often get, you know, complaints from neighbours. So we have got methodology, and we at times we hire experts from USP to go and measure the volume of emission, the dust levels, whether it complies with the international standards that are set. And for example, there was an issue from cement factory. And then, you know, and it's not that the factory needs to be closed. There are certain gadgets that they need to fit in that will ensure that that particular emission is minimized or dealt with, and then it doesn't become hazardous for the community or the households that are around. So, Honourable Speaker, say under Part 5 of the Environmental Management Regulation 2007, it is an offence to burn tyres, household garbage within municipal boundaries, burning of fire coated with any material, open burning of oil and burning of bitumen or tarmac used for surfacing roads. Honourable Speaker, say. I wish to state categorically here that it is an offence under the Environment Regulation 2007 for burning of waste, burning of tyres within the municipal boundaries or any wire-coated material. And if a person is found to have committed that particular offence, the penalty is $10,000. So that is why, Honourable Speaker, I say we have stopped providing incinerators to like it used to happen those days. You're not allowed to burn rubbishes. You're not allowed to burn tyres, etc. Thank you.